But how do you see Hollywood right now? I mean, this in this moment of history.
Well, actually, it's funny because, I mean, it's like over recently we've been talking about the, you know, political aspects of film. I mean, it's like propaganda becoming such a big part, especially like those 80s movies and everything. I didn't even realize until yesterday, until we were talking about it, that, you know, a lot of, like Rambo, for instance, is a propaganda film, you know? You know.
Avatar.
Avatar.
Sí, pues el cine es manipulación, ¿no? Y finalmente creo que somos tramposos y mentirosos, ¿no? Para generar un efecto. Claro, todo es, claro, claro. Hasta una nota periodística, ¿no? En un medio impreso, por supuesto, ¿no? Y de eso se trata. Hay veces que dicen, ese documental es objetivo. Es que, ¿qué tan objetivo puede ser? ¿No? Es muy, muy difícil, ¿no?
Sí, porque normalmente un documental habla de una sola parte, pero también está la otra parte, que la mejor.
Es la visión de una persona.
Exacto. De una persona. Y es más, desde donde está colocada la cámara. Ya desde ahí es un punto de vista subjetivo, ¿no? Well, actually, James Cameron wrote Rambo: First Blood Part 2.
Yeah, and that's right? Very Cold War.
Of course. So it's interesting to see that, you know, at least from my perspective. When I was watching Avatar, I forgot that James Cameron
did Rambo.
co-wrote Rambo with Stallone. Yeah. I don't think Stallone really sat down for hours and hours and hours and wrote that, but they co-wrote the film. So when I was watching it, I said, shit, this is Rambo.
Yeah.
He falls in love with one of the local girls, with one of the local warriors, and teaches him certain aspects of life in the jungle. So I said, this is Rambo. And people don't really get it, you know, but it's I mean, they're not as obsessed with film as others are, like us.
Yeah.
But that's interesting. And that's how I think different kinds of systems control society.
Yeah.